DC, would it make you feel better if I told you that we have a life-size poster of you now in the world-famous avocado room?
It would. You know, I mean, it's about time that I get some credit over there at UFC Tonight. I've always been the second leg, you know, to Kenny Florian, and I got some big shoes to fill on there.
That is not true.
So, DC, Timmy Toehold had us all bugging up laughing, but what I wasn't laughing about is your old Big 12 comrade, the Strike First guy. I hear you had my man Kenny Florian come out to AKA and train with you a little bit. On a scale of 1 to 10, what type of coach is Kenny Florian?
He's great, man. I tell you one thing. You know, the guy's a third-degree black belt for a reason. There were little details that he showed me in the grappling that I've already started to implement into my game. You know, it's very late in the camp, and I've been able to use some of the things that he showed me already with a lot of success in my sparring. So I really enjoyed it. I appreciated him actually taking the time to come up and visit me. And, you know, man, we work together in friendships. You know, you don't really know how big they are until you realize Kenny's been sending me fight breakdowns every time I fight, and now he's actually made his presence known at AKA to help me. So I really do value Kenny as a friend, as a partner, and now as a coach.
Well, I can't take offense now, Kenny. He just made you this amazing guy, so.
I had a great time up there, man, in NorCal. Listen, I'll give you that $20 I owe you, I promise. Thank you for that. Listen, what did you learn from the first fight? How is this fight going to be different against AJ?
He was a lot faster than I thought. You know, I am anticipating a much better rumble. You know, I think that he's going to address the areas that I gave him problems in. But the difference is going to be that I'm going to beat him a lot worse than I did the first time. I know who Anthony Johnson is, and he's a big, dangerous guy. But I'm not afraid of him in the least bit. And me not being afraid is the first step in going in there and breaking his spirit and just dominating him again.
Well, speaking of breaking the spirit, DC, everybody knows you as the king of the grind. You were one of the best at the dirty boxing, getting in close, takedowns from the clinch and against the cage. We all know his striking ability. Have you guys done something different in camp to close that gap, to get close where you do the best work?
Yeah, you know what, man? Last time I was reactive. I was actually reacting to his strikes to take him down. This time I want to take the initiative. So Anthony has to pick his poison. You know, he can actually spaz out and have a chance of having success, or he can try to be patient as he did in the Phil Davis fight. If he tries to be patient, I am literally going to run him over. So he better spaz out, or it's going to be an even longer night for him. If he tries to stay the patience, man, then I'm really going to just charge at him and really just demolish him. So if you're listening, Rumble, you better spaz out, because that makes you dangerous. If you try to stay within yourself, you're going to get smashed on even worse.
DC, you know, you have two of the best fighters in the world in your camp. Luke Rockhold, Cain Velasquez, of course. Were they available for this camp in preparation for AJ?
You know, Cain was available in the same capacity that he was the first time, where he can come in and do light sparring, where he can't go 100%, but he can go. Cain's 60% is so much harder than everybody else's 100%. So just moving with him. Luke Rockhold's been there consistently. When Cain isn't sparring, he's there as a coach. So I've got my guys, you know, and I get a lot of confidence from that. I don't know if Rumble could beat Luke or beat Cain. So I gain confidence from knowing that I train with those guys on a daily basis.
Well, DC, I got to say one thing. That beard game is looking strong. I know you're trying to match my beard. You're getting close. few ticks on the left, few ticks on the right. You're right in the mix. Appreciate you, brother. Best of luck. We'll see you at UFC 210.
I appreciate y'all. A.T. Wood, don't get too comfortable. Daddy's coming home after this.
I already put my bobblehead there, man.
Daddy's coming home. Don't you dare move my Apple box. You know I got those bad knees, need my legs to rest when I'm sitting.